Good morning. I'm sick as a dog, as you all know if you're following my YouTubes. First of all, we're back to pre the election, Mike Bloomberg, the media being his puppets. Not one newspaper has reported that Mike Bloomberg was booed yesterday. He was booed at the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory Memorial. And people even yelled out things like, you care about safety, then why did you close our firehouses? Why are you closing firehouses? And no one reported it except me. Number two, New York Daily News, CityTime. CityTime crooks banks boxes empty, says the feds. Well, I'm the only one that I'm aware of that ever reported Gerald Shargel is the defense attorney for Mazur, the alleged mastermind in the $80 million theft. So Gerald Shargel says, well, it's a stretch, in response to the feds saying, well, it looks like the boxes have been cleared out. Well, Gerald Shargel's like, dude, that's a stretch. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? Mike Bloomberg, are you kidding me? And also, read my blog. I have a bunch of postings I'll put in the text section about how Ed Koch is on Mike Bloomberg's payroll, and you look at Charlie Rose is Mike Bloomberg's Ken doll. So when Mike Bloomberg's best friend and the New York Daily News' best friend and the New York Times owner's best friends, money manager Steve Ratner gets busted for pay to play, they just put him on Charlie Rose and pretend he didn't do anything wrong and let him plug his baloney full of baloney book about being the hero of the auto industry. So thanks for tuning in. I'm not feeling well, and I will have more information. Go to my blog. Thank you. Gerald Shargel, explain to me, because it's fascinating. Where did Mazur get the money to pay you? Are you doing a pro bono? You are a Gambino family mafia lawyer. So I'm just confused where this guy, he was a city worker, and then he becomes a consultant, and he's got the money, everything, all his boxes and everything that's empty, but he's got the money to pay your bills. Please just explain it to me. Now, I'm entitled as an American and an artist to have an opinion. So based on what I read about Mazur, and it's heinous in my opinion, when he worked for New York City government, it appears to me that he was stealing from the get-go, like he's a compulsive shoplifter.